Welcome back, friends, to another weekly video. The stock market continues to be very volatile. This last week, the Dow had its largest drop in 3 months, dropping 6.9% in 1 day. Economic news continues to be grim. I thought a lot this week on how to communicate what is really going on in the economy. How bad really is the economy? And I actually came up with something new. And this is something I think is going to shock you. So in this video, I'm going to talk about something I call hatch analysis. I think a lot of people are looking at the current economic recession incorrectly. A lot of people are looking at this recession as being caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. But I think what is going on is actually based in larger systemic problems. And these are economic problems that have been building for a very long time. Something economists have talked about for a while is that wages are stagnant in the US. You've probably seen a chart like this one, which shows wages versus the purchasing power adjusted for inflation. What this shows is that wages have been flat in the US for a very long time. People are not making any more money. But just looking at this chart, it's hard to understand what this really means for people's lives. And I think the best way to understand this is through something I call hatch analysis. Now, you will not hear about this in business school because I just came up with this idea for this video. So what is hatch analysis? Hatch is an acronym for typical major purchases. So hatch stands for housing, auto, college, and healthcare. And the point of looking at these four areas is you're trying to understand people's options in life. When people are going through their lives and they're making financial decisions, these are four main areas that really drive people's choices. The first step is to look at people's wages. So I pulled median household income from the US Census Bureau from 1967 to today. Now that we understand income, we want to look at the four hatch expenses against this income. And I'm going to quickly put up my assumptions and data sources so you can see how I did my calculations. And I basically looked at each of these areas to see what percentage of income would be spent on each expense every year based on the changes in price. Now that we've evaluated the data in each of the four areas of the hatch analysis, we can put it all together in one chart. And you'll notice that this looks very similar to the chart I showed earlier from professional economists. And it essentially shows the very same thing. While wages have stayed stagnant, expenses in these four major areas have experienced massive inflation. These are four areas that account for very large purchases that really impact people's lives. The inflation numbers in these areas are huge. So if we look at the prices as a percentage of income, you really start to understand the impact of this change. Here is a table of the percentage of household income the purchase would take as an average within each decade. In 1970, housing, auto, college, and healthcare together only took up 11% of the household income. So you could buy each of those four items and still have 89% of your income to spend on something else. By 2020, these four items would take 76% of the household income. The remaining 24% would be available for other things like utilities and food. So what this hatch analysis is showing is actually something very nuanced. So this is not showing what people are actually spending their money on. These are just prices in the market. So no one is actually spending 76% of their income on these four items. That's not what's happening. What this analysis is representing is people's choices in life. In 1970, you could easily choose to have these four things: housing, auto, college, and healthcare. That's not true today. People have to make trade-off decisions. So people are deciding whether to go out and buy medicine or have a roof over their head. Or people are deciding whether to go to college or go out and buy a house and start a family. These are difficult decisions driven by these prices in the market. You can't have everything anymore. And this shows why life in the United States has become so hard over the last 5 decades. People who started their careers in the 70s had completely different life choices than people who are starting their careers today. My point is that the economic problems that we are facing today are not just from the pandemic. They're deep systemic problems in the economy that have been building up for a very long time. Now, people use these type of charts a lot to attack the Fed with printing money as the cause for inflation. But you have to be very careful with that argument because inflation is much more complicated than that. Not all prices across the economy are rising. These are 4 very specific sectors that have experienced massive inflation, but there isn't inflation in all sectors. You can find a lot of sectors where prices are dropping. Computers, for instance, prices have been dropping. Things like furniture, prices are going down. Clothing, prices are going down. So basically, anything that can be exported and manufactured outside of the United States, prices are going down. So when you look at this chart, the problems with this chart are not driven by inflation. It's driven by globalization. The hatch expenses are all areas that cannot be outsourced outside of the US, and so prices are increasing. However, jobs can be outsourced, which is keeping wages stagnant. It's not possible for the Federal Reserve to increase inflation fast enough because the jobs will just continue to leave overseas. So what is the solution? It seems like a pretty impossible problem, but I believe the solution is actually pretty simple. And the solution will not only address the immediate economic concerns caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, it will also address the longer-term fundamental issues we're experiencing in our economy. The solution is space jobs. This is a solution I talk about all the time on this channel, and it works for a number of reasons. Space jobs cannot be exported. All space manufacturing is protected under ITAR regulations, which stands for International Traffic in Arms Regulations. This means that all space manufacturing has to happen inside the United States. 2, space jobs are good, high-paying aerospace jobs, most of which can be done from home during this pandemic. So these are the types of jobs that raise household incomes. All you have to do to fix this chart is to raise the income. 3, we currently have the technology to make all of this possible. This is a photo of a top secret space plane called the X-37. Now, it's hard to get a good image of this. This photo is from military.com. This is a space plane the US is using today. The government has the construction drawings. So why aren't we building a whole fleet of these things? Why are we not building spaceport infrastructure in every state in the United States? We could be creating millions of high-paying space jobs that can't be exported. The 4th reason this is such a good idea is that this is an area of strategic competitive advantage for the United States. This is building up a brand new industry where other countries have a hard time competing. This is also a way for the US to increase manufacturing and start producing things again. I know a lot of you will be critical. You're going to think this is science fiction. You're going to think this is fantasy, but it's not that crazy. The Federal Reserve during this crisis increased the US balance sheet to $7 trillion. That's an increase of $2.8 trillion since this crisis began. Most of this was to inject liquidity into the market by giving people more debt. Instead of investing all that money in bad debt, what if we gave Americans space jobs at $100,000 each? That would create 28 million new jobs. That's almost the same number of jobs that have been lost so far this recession at a much higher salary. These are just ballpark numbers. The exact numbers are not really important here, because the point of the Hatch analysis is to show you that any investment in any number of space jobs will have a huge impact on improving people's lives in this economy today. The way out of this crisis is not more debt in the system. It is allowing Americans to work their way out of the crisis and build a new industry in the process. Before you call me crazy, if you know your business history, you will realize that we have done something very similar to this before. During the Great Depression, the U.S. formed something called the Civilian Conservation Corps, or the CCC. This program provided jobs for the unemployed during the Great Depression over a period of 9 years. These jobs were focused on building state and national parks across the country that we enjoy today. I think it is time to do something similar to the temporary CCC program, but instead of building national parks, let's create space jobs. The infrastructure needed will take some government investment. But as we've already seen in the space industry today, with a little bit of government investment, private companies will then follow and continue to grow the space industry. In short, the state of the economy is pretty bad. But this isn't anywhere that we haven't been before. There are solutions, and the United States can work their way out of this crisis. I'm Zach. From Wolves in Finance, thank you so much for watching. Let's go out and make some money.